I would like to welcome you and thank you for attending the Spring Sports Awards Ceremony. I'm honored to be able to begin this evening by recognizing our scholar athletes. I take pride in recognizing the student athlete for academic achievements. As you know, there are great demands placed on our student athletes both during competition and during the school day. It is my pleasure to recognize our spring scholar athletes who have not only met the stringent requirements set by their coaches, but also excelled in the classroom. Athletes, please stand as your sports honorees are called. Please hold your applause until all scholar athletes for that sport are standing. For the baseball team, Brett Abbott, Chase Brown, Kara Brown, Zach Deshaun, Peyton Dovich, Zane Duff, Austin Foster, Jake Good, who was an All-A student, Alec Holland, Carter Hooks, Tanner Music, Briley Towell, and Terry Walker. For men's golf, Trey Adley, Killian Bailey, who earned all A's, Daniel Butler, Jackson Jones, who earned all A's, Aaron Orr, Jackson Sawyer, who earned all A's, and Josh Wooten. On the softball team, Alexis Elliott earned all A's, Courtney Gast, Libby Good earned all A's, Alexa Holland earned all A's, Lexi Holland earned all A's, Catherine Hughes, Becky Long earned all A's, Becky Malco earned all A's, Kennedy Musselman, Corey Rao earned all A's, Morgan Ruff earned all A's, Maddie Shively and Taryn Stockberger earned all A's. On the women's tennis team, Emma Berrettini, Allie Bickle earned all A's, Zoe Bixler earned all A's, Grace Dakey earned all A's, Claire Dunwoody earned all A's, Gabby Goss earned all A's, Allie Harsh, Ariana Jacobs earned all A's, Maddie Karenko, Abby McCarter earned all A's, Rosalie Navarro earned all A's, Lillian Scott, Adrian Shepard earned all A's. Trisha Timmons earned all A's. Min An Vu earned all A's. And Mariah Yoakum. On the track team, Sam Adams, Nicholas Bohack, Jacob Bowman earned all A's. Mason Brady, Adam Brown earned all A's. Jayla Burkett, Emma Dahlquist earned all A's, Cody Dennis earned all A's, Helene Drake, Alexa Garrison, Zane Gilbreth earned all A's, John Tay Harper earned all A's, Maddie Hyatt, Michaela Hyatt, Austin Hoover, Jana Kuhn, Connor McLaughlin, Wesley Meyer, Lorenzo Modiano, Chaz Nelson, Jacob Nye, Megan Nile, Ben Perez earned all A's, Karina Peterson, Matthew Pickens, Gary Plummer, Jerry Plummer, Eli Pugh earned all A's, Jeffrey Rupert, Maddie Sailors, Amanda Sager, Paige Schaefer, Isaac Smith earned all A's, Nicole Spencer, Kelsey Tyler, Allie Ulry, Sierra Weathers, and Amber Willard earned all A's. The next award we're going to give out is for honorable mention all TRC scholar athletes. To earn honorable mention, a student must be on the varsity squad, rank in the top 30% of their class, and carry a 3.4 GPA or higher. Athletes, when you are called, please come to the stage. On the baseball team, Brett Abbott. On the golf team, Killian Bailey. On the track team, Nicholas Bohack. On the tennis team, Rosalie Navarro. Our next award is for first team all TRC scholar athletes. To earn first team honors, an athlete must be on the varsity squad, rank in the top 15%, and have a grading period GPA of 3.8 or higher. Athletes, again, please come to the stage. On the baseball team, there isn't anybody, I shouldn't have said that. On the golf team, Jackson Sawyer and Jackson Jones. On the softball team, Taryn Stockberger, Libby Good, Alexa Holland, Lexi Holland, and Becky Malko. On the tennis team, Claire Dunwoody, Ariana Jacobs, and Zoe Bixler. On the track team, Ben Perez, Alexa Garrison, Eli Pugh, and Wesley Meyer. Also on the track team, Maddie Hyatt.
I'd like to welcome everyone to tonight's awards. And before we give out our captain's award, our most promising, our most improved, our mental attitude and MVP awards in here, I'd like to go over some team accomplishments and just some notable achievements from our athletes through the school year. Spring sports are always a little odd because we have seasons that are still underway. So with that in mind, I want to wish the best of luck to those still competing in the IHSAA tournaments. First boys golf sectionals take place this Friday, June 3rd at Dykeman Golf Course in Logansport. Last year, the team made it to regionals, and this year they had invite wins over Logansport and LaVille, and we're very optimistic for our finishes this week. Team finished second in the TRC, and Killian Bailey, Aaron Orr, and Jackson Sawyer all made the TRC All-Conference team. Congratulations to those golfers. We're also still alive in track. Wesley Meyer and Eli Pugh compete this Saturday at the Robert C. Hall Track and Field Memorial Complex at Indiana University in Bloomington. Both runners have had outstanding seasons. Meyer's a sectional and regional champion in two events, the 1600 and 800 meter runs. He's qualified for the state finals in both events for the second straight season. He also established a new 1600 record at RHS, running 4:16.82 this past week at the Warsaw Regional. As for Pugh, he's a state qualifier in the 3,200 meter run. He also notched TRC championships in two events, the 1600 and 800. Some other notable track performances this year. Jeff Rupert was the TRC pole vault champ and was a regional qualifier in that event. Ben Perez qualified for regionals in the 110 and 300 hurdles. Eli Pugh also qualified for regionals in the 1600 and 3,200 relay. That relay team was Pugh, Meyer, Zane Gilbreth, and Cody Dennis. For the girls, Riley Schaefer qualified for regionals in shot put and discus, and Kelsey Tyler qualified in the 3,200-meter run. Congratulations to the track team. Also, I'd like to take the opportunity to congratulate the girls' tennis team, who in 2016 earned the school's first IHSAA sectional title and snapped an 11-season win streak for CMA at their place. The team finished with an 11-5 season record, were 6-2 in the conference, and this was just announced today. Zoe Bixler was named to the Three Rivers Conference first team, and Allie Bickle and Ariana Jacobs were awarded honorable mention. Congratulations. Baseball and softball are in a little different place right now. They don't hold their all-conference voting until Monday, so we'll wait for those accolades to become official. We are optimistic, though, that we will have representation at the North-South game on June 18th for softball, so we're pretty excited about that, although that hasn't been official yet, so we'll make an announcement when that becomes a reality. I'd also like to recognize softball team for victories at the LaPorte Classic and the Wawa Sea Invitational. Congratulations to softball and baseball. And the spring season is a little different because this is the time when we honor our senior athletes for the accomplishments they've had throughout their careers here. These next group of seniors are earning special conference distinction in their RHS careers. Seniors, as I talk about you, you don't really need to come up or anything, but I do want to publicly acknowledge your accomplishment. The Three Rivers Conference awards three types of awards. The first one is the TRC Mental Attitude Award. To qualify for that award, an athlete must be a senior on the varsity squad. They have to be nominated by their coach, athletic director, or principal, and they must excel in mental attitude, athletic ability, scholarship, and leadership for 4 years. They also have to meet minimum requirements of having a 1500 SAT or 21 ACT and rank in the top 15% of their class. The second type of award that is given is the TRC Distinguished Athlete Award, which is given to those who make the academic all-TRC team in at least 5 out of 6 seasons during their junior and senior years. And the third type is a very special award called the TRC Scholar Athlete Award. To be eligible for this award, you have to have been nominated for the Mental Attitude Award. You have to have a minimum SAT score of 1850 or an ACT composite score of 27, and you have to rank in the top 5% of your class going into your 8th semester in school. So these were the recipients of the Three Rivers Conference Awards. Jace Bixler received the TRC Mental Attitude Award for swimming and the TRC Distinguished Athlete Award for making academic all-TRC 5 out of his 6 eligible seasons. Libby Good received the TRC Mental Attitude Award for volleyball and the TRC Distinguished Athlete Award for making the academic all-TRC team 5 out of 6 of her eligible seasons. Alexa Holland received the TRC Distinguished Athlete Award for making the academic all-TRC team each of her 6 eligible seasons. Wesley Meyer received the TRC Mental Attitude Award for track and field and the TRC Distinguished Athlete Award for making the academic all-TRC team all 6 seasons. Katie Schaller received the TRC Distinguished Athlete Award for making the academic all-TRC team 5 out of 6 seasons. She was also nominated for the TRC Mental Attitude Award in soccer and swimming. Eli Pugh received all 3 awards. He received the TRC Mental Attitude Award for cross country, the TRC Distinguished Athlete Award for qualifying in all 6 seasons, and was the sole RHS recipient of the TRC Scholar Athlete Award. And Michael Whitfield received the TRC Mental Attitude Award for soccer. Congratulations to those seniors for those honors. Another type of special award that is given at the end of the year are the Blanket Awards. The Blanket Award at Rochester High School is earned by accumulating 60 points or more during an athletic career. An athlete earns 7 points for each varsity letter won, 5 points for each season as a varsity manager, 3 points for freshman or junior varsity participation, 2 points as a statistician or other support groups such as MapMates. In almost every case, a young man or young lady who earns this award has to be involved year-round as an athlete, manager, or trainer. In addition to having the 60 points, an athlete has to exhibit good citizenship and behavior, and each Blanket Award winner must have defended all letters earned during their junior and senior sports seasons. In the class of 2016, there were 94 students who competed over the past 4 years. Only 11 of those athletes met the criteria for this award. So I'll ask Mr. Strasser to please hand out the blankets as these seniors come to the stage. The first recipient is Brett Abbott, who participated in 12 seasons, earning 3 varsity letters in football, 3 in basketball, and 4 in baseball. Brett accumulated 76 points toward the award. Alec Holland participated in 10 sports seasons, earning 1 varsity letter in football, 1 in tennis, 4 in basketball, and 4 in baseball. Alec earned 63 points toward the award. Alexa Holland competed in 12 sports seasons, earning 3 varsity letters in soccer, 4 in basketball, and 4 in softball. She earned 80 points toward the award. Connor McLaughlin competed in 9 sports seasons, earning 4 varsity letters in football, 1 in wrestling, and 4 in track. He accumulated 63 points toward the award. Wesley Meyer competed and lettered in 12 sports seasons, 4 in cross country, 4 in swimming, and 4 in track. He earned a perfect score of 84 points toward the blanket award. Aaron Orr competed in 12 sports seasons at RHS, earning 2 varsity letters in soccer, 4 in wrestling, and 4 in golf. He earned 73 points toward the award. Eli Pugh competed in 12 sports seasons and earned 3 letters in cross country, 4 in swimming, and 4 in track. He accumulated 80 points towards the award. Thomas Rensberger competed in 10 sports seasons, earning 2 varsity letters in football, 4 in wrestling, and 2 in baseball. He accumulated 62 points toward the award. Morgan Tyler competed in 9 sports seasons. She earned 4 varsity letters in soccer, 4 in swimming, and 1 in track. She tallied 62 points toward the award, and I'm wondering if one of her siblings can accept it for her. This is your big moment. Brothers Deshaun Whitfield and Michael Whitfield both earned the award. They both competed in 10 sports seasons. They earned varsity letters in soccer, 4 varsity letters in soccer, 3 in wrestling, and 2 in track. Each earned 66 points toward the award. We'll now go into our sports awards for each sport for the spring. Our first is team captains. According to our athletic manual, the description of captains is that leadership is often the intangible that is missing on those teams that never seem to fulfill their potential. At the same time, it is often very evident on those teams that rise to championship levels. Team captains must serve as leaders, as recruiters, as assistant coaches for the younger players, and as positive role models for all team members. Coach Stahlbaum, you are up, and the award is team captains.
I deserve that. For those of you that were at Fall Sports Awards, I'm not very good at following directions. I had to make sure this wasn't my grocery list. I didn't want to start reading that out loud. That'd be pretty embarrassing. So, all right, our captains. I'll go with girls first. We had 2 captains. One was more because of her kind of tenacity and her dedication to be as good as she possibly could be, and the other one is more positive role model. Positive role model was Maddie Hyatt. And the one that's a little bit more tenacious is Emma Dahlquist. On the boys' side, we had 2 juniors, actually, who were going to get this. And I thought they just were just absolutely fabulous all year. They really, really, I think the entire coaching staff was really impressed on how well they just interacted with the team and how they really talked to the young sprinters specifically, one of which basically was our hurdle coach. So Ben Perez was our hurdle coach this year, and Jacob Nye, also a team captain.
All right, the captain of the boys baseball team this year, four-year varsity starter. I'm not sure that he missed a game in 4 years. He can probably answer that question better than I can. But went about his business on a daily basis, never got too high or too low on himself, really kept us, you know, our guys' heads up. And without him on the field, we were a completely different team. This year's captain, Alec Holland.
Our captains won three TRC titles, and honestly, our captains have so much experience that it made my job really, really easy. Our captains brought their own uniqueness to the team. They led by example. They were our vocal leaders, took charge where needed, and all played key roles on our team. This year's captains, Alexa Holland, Becky Malko, and Lexanne Holland.
This year's golf team was compromised of a lot of upperclassmen. All of them were very strong leaders in our team that influenced a lot of success that we had. All worked very hard in practice. There were two young men that really stood out a little more and that Lyle and I relied on a little extra in practice. Our two captains this year are Aaron Orr and Daniel Butler.
All right, so this year, we as a coaching staff on the tennis team decided to try and focus on a little more than just the X's and O's of tennis. Tried to focus a little more on, leadership, culture building, and things like that. And these two individuals who are the captains all throughout the year really embraced the process, even when they really didn't want to at times. And we're very grateful for that. So this year our captains were Zoe Bixler and Mariah Yoakum.
If I were staying in this capacity any longer, I would arrange the order of coaches by height. Jesse would never go before me. It's important that coaches continue to work hard and recruit the best possible athletes for their sport. It's especially gratifying when a coach gets a young man or lady in their freshman or sophomore year to show the talent, potential, and determination and the positive attitude to be a real champion in their high school career. Hopefully, the awards earned tonight as most promising will serve to encourage each of these athletes onto bigger and better seasons in their RHS careers.
On the guys' side, it was really, really close. Actually, the coaches, the four of us, were really split on this, on figuring out who it was going to be. So I'm going to name them both for now and then pick one. that way we get a little credit for the other person, you know what I mean? It's cheating, I know. So Cody Dennis, I think, scored a lot more points this year and has the ability, I think, maybe to go to state someday. But Liam Leininger has some raw athleticism, and he was just, this is his first year ever doing this. And he did four different kinds of events for us. And because of that, I think Liam has the potential to score a lot more points for us over the next couple of years. So we're both of them are really, really good. We got this slight edge to Liam Leininger. On the girls' side, it's very rare that we have a person who does shot put, hurdles, and long jump, and be a freshman. Those are four completely different events to train for, and it's really hard to do. And actually, it's pretty taxing on her throughout the year. But you know, no matter how much pain she was in, you know, trying to train for those four, she never complained about it. And she's going to be really, really good, Karina Peterson.
This year's most promising athlete for the baseball team started all 23 games of the varsity season. He pitched, played third, short, first, center, left, right, second in a JV game, so anywhere but catcher. Led the team in 9 offensive categories as a freshman, Brady Perez.
I'm just a rule follower. I stuck right with the script here. For our most promising, we had a couple freshmen come in that were on a middle school team last year that won the middle school conference, and they're polar opposites in a lot of ways. One is a lot bigger and stronger than the other, and one swings from the inside, and one swings a little from the outside, and Monty and I discussed this a little bit as to how we were going to decide who got what, but we certainly know that in the future we're going to need both of them. We're going to need both of them to step up and contribute heavily. The one that we ended up giving it to, he came in, he contended for a top 5 spot very early in the season, actually ended up in a playoff for the last spot with 2 other guys that were both seniors. He has a very athletic motion. Creates a lot of clubhead speed for his size, and he's working on shots right now that he's not really comfortable with. So I appreciate him going along with me on that journey and not worrying so much about his score and trying to just do what we're asking him to do so that in the future he'll be able to contribute even more. He shows a real passion to improve, and that's something that you really want from these people that are promising, because a lot of times they have some talent, but maybe they don't have the desire to work at it. And I see him come, and when he's not hitting it well, he's very frustrated, and he goes back out and wants to hit more balls, and that's the thing that we need. So I know in the future he's going to be a very top-notch golfer, and he'll be a major contributor to the varsity next season. Our most promising is Jacob Miller.
As a freshman, she was our varsity's number 2 pitcher while helping us win the Wawa C tournament and having a 5-2 record for the JV and hitting close to 400. I look forward to what the future will bring for this young lady, Elena Richard.
Yeah.
All right. This year, our most promising athlete came to us a little bit late. I gave this individual tennis lessons when she was very, very, well, much younger than what she is now, and hoped and prayed that she would come out when she got to high school. She didn't. She came to us this year, like I said, in her junior year. She has a whole lot of potential, and we're looking forward to, you know, what she can do next year in her senior year. That is Claire Dunwoody.
One of the goals of every sports program is to continue to strive for improvement. Whether that means a better time in the 3,200 meter run, a higher batting average, or fewer putts per round, improvement is often the key to many of the successes of our athletic programs. Our next award is Most Improved.
I think both these people were probably fairly frustrated with their times last year, and both of them are much happier with the way the season went this year. They dropped a whole lot of time, and I think they got a lot more confidence, which is going to be great going forward. Our boy most improved is Harrison Korkos. Again, same story on the girls' side. A lot of time drop, really confident going forward, and that's Kelsey Tyler.
Most improved this year, this young man went from hitting 286 last year as a junior to hitting 354 this year as a senior. Tremendous leader on and off the field. He caught in 20 of our 23 games, hit his first career homer against McConaughey, Tanner Music.
This year on the golf team, this young man, his first match of the season, he shot a 58, was very disappointed in himself, expected a lot more. A few days later, he shoots a 63, things are getting a little worse, he's getting a little disappointed. But he continued to work throughout the season, got better, his putting improved. Last two matches of the season, he shoots 49 and 50. Happy for this young man. Our most improved is Wes Scobie.
Really?
Last year, this young lady hit 203 overall and 250 in the TRC conference. This year, she improved and hit 362 overall and 458 in conference. Big improvement at the plate and behind the plate. She was the force that we expected. I guess you need to know. Kennedy Musselman.
All right, this year's most improved in girls tennis. Last year, found herself somewhere in the middle of the JV lineup. Was not 100% convinced until about a week in of this season that she was going to play. Came back, and once she was eligible, played varsity for us in every match that we played from that point on. at the end of the season when she walked off the court, having won a sectional championship. I asked her if she was a little, you know, happy with her decision to come out and play tennis this year, and she just started giggling because that's who she is. This year's most improved is Abby McCarter.
Next award is Mental Attitude. The coach's favorite person may be a way you could describe this award, and it's true in many ways. And the question that needs to be asked is, why is this player the coach's favorite? And the answer is always because they always listen in practice and try to do what's right. They always hustle during their practices as well as in contests. They always try to provide leadership and be a positive example for the underclassmen in the program. Talent and potential are not qualities needed to win the Mental Attitude Award, but a never-say-die attitude coupled with a positive outlook on life are the qualities of this award winner.
All right, we'll start with boys. This guy had me laughing so hard that I cried on the way to one of our meets. So if for any other reason, he helped my mental attitude, which was really nice. And I think he did the same for a lot of other people on the team. And I know how encouraging he was. I know Ken Hughes talked about how great he was over at the throws every day at practice and encouraging the young guys. Sam Adams. Which he's not here. On the girls' side, I think she was a freshman, actually. We had a lot of freshmen on the team this year. And she just has a really positive attitude towards life in general. And she's really kind of giddy all the time. And I think it rubs off on the rest of the team and kind of relaxes everybody, especially at the big meets. And unfortunately, she wasn't able to run sectionals because she had an injury with her back. But I would have loved to see her compete. Sierra Weathers.
The Mental Attitude winner this year, the baseball team, had a rough start to a senior season, struggled a little bit at the plate, listened to the coaching staff, tweaked his stance a little bit, and tripled his hits in the last seven games of the season. I asked his dad if a Ballew's ever won this award before, and he couldn't give me a straight answer, so this year's Mental Attitude, Clay Ballew.
Monty and I were just thinking how sad that was. We had Clay as a freshman. He could have been a golfer instead, you know. We could add another Mental Attitude Award winner right here. The Golf Mental Attitude Award goes to a player who put in a lot of time this year. You know, a lot of times when you have a long week of practice, and we do some morning practices as well as some afternoon practices, they have some long days that are invitationals on the weekends. And a lot of times guys just want to take Sunday off, and I surely don't blame them for that. I understand that. But our Mental Attitude Award winner has shown up several times at the course on Sunday afternoon, a little bit frustrated, a little bit determined to work out the kinks in his game. And he's typically a very easygoing young man. He doesn't have a lot of technical swing thoughts. He doesn't care whether there's any hinge in your wrist rotation there. And sometimes when we talk, I'm not sure we're on the same wavelength. I'm very technical, so I speak in technical terms a lot, and sometimes I think I confuse him more than not, but he seems to really hit his stride lately. I've enjoyed watching his effort this spring and his desire to improve and develop his game. Our Mental Attitude Award winner is affectionately known to us as Exxon, because of his oily, smooth motion, and that's Jackson Jones.
Really?
This player received the most votes from her teammates, which means more when you see a player keep a positive attitude even when the coaches aren't looking. And then her own teammates recognize that. This is an accomplishment to that player. She is a steady player, she's very positive toward others. She's kind-hearted and always trying to get better. Lexi Elliott.
For us this year, mental attitude really was a pretty easy decision for our coaching staff. This individual, if I had my way, every single person on my team, on any of my teams, would essentially approach the sport in the day-to-day exactly how this individual does. When she's at practice, she's there, she's mentally ready, she's ready to go in matches. She's tough to beat. She really, truly is. This is a very, very talented young lady in tennis and in life, quite frankly. This year's mental attitude, Allie Bickle.
Next award is for most valuable athlete. Our definition of most valuable athlete is the person who means the most to the team. The most valuable athlete is not necessarily the most talented, but is the player who contributes the most to the program. The most valuable athlete must provide leadership and also exhibit outstanding skill in the sport. One way to determine the most valuable athlete is to simply ask the question, where would this team have been without this person?
For track, it's separated into field events, so most valuable field event person and most valuable running event person, because the events are so different. There's 16 events in track. So we'll start with the field events first. For guys track, this person was a TRC champion. So out of the 10 schools in the TRC, he was the best one. And he's only a sophomore, so he's going to only get better from here. And I think he has somebody who's a potential state qualifier someday, Jeffrey Rupert. Our most valuable field event, this person's junior. She qualified for regionals in both discus and shot put. She also made the finals in discus, and we haven't had a girl make it to finals in discus in a while. She's a junior, so she can come back next year, and she got that regional, got some practice at it to see what it's like, so I think she's going to do really good next year. Riley Schaefer. I know I'm up here for a while. For running events, we'll start with girls first. This was kind of a hard decision because we have several people who score a whole lot of points in the running events. But we thought this person is the most versatile. She also does a field event as well. And she continually scores the most points for the team, meet in, meet out when she's healthy. Maddie Sailors. Okay, this one, we decided to give two of them for the boys' side because we have two people who are just outstanding seniors. They own lots of school records. I think Wesley Meyer owns, five total school records between three different sports. And I know Eli Pugh has two swimming records, and he's really, really close to getting the 2-mile record. I think he'll actually get it this Saturday if the weather's good. So these guys have just been awesome. I think Wesley's got double digit sectional titles in individual events. And Eli is now a state qualifier in the 2 mile. So they've been two of the best athletes I have ever coached and probably will ever coach. And I'm really going to miss them, especially their bickering like old married couple on every workout they've ever done, ever. One time, actually, I'll tell you the story since I got everybody, attention. One time, because they like to follow each other in workouts and like draft off each other. One time, I think I'm going to blame Wesley. I'm actually going to blame Eli. Eli was getting too close because he likes to draft Wesley all the time. Got too close up to him in a 300s workout, and they fell. And so it was like right before regionals last year, they were all cut up. So that was great. And I didn't have a heart attack or anything, but that's kind of normal. And then at the end, they always yell at each other, but they still love each other. It's kind of crazy. So I'm going to miss them a lot, and they are really awesome track and field athletes. Wesley Meyer, Eli Pugh.
Without this player on the team this year, I really don't want to know what it would have been like. He was kind of the glue that held us all together. Whenever we needed a pickup, he was there. Whenever he was in the field or up to bat, you knew we had a shot. Great 4 years from this kid. This year's most valuable, Alec Collin.
Golf's most valuable was an easy choice this year. He's had our lowest scoring average, I know, last year, and I think possibly even the year before by the time the season was over. His scores always count. His scores are almost always the lowest. He posted the lowest Rochester High School boys score since the late 1980s, back when I graduated, by shooting a 1 under par 69 at Rosella Ford at the Warsaw Invitational this year. He puts in the most off-season work. He plays the most off-season events. He practices with a great intention to improve. And he's our MVP, Killian Crunch Bailey.
We had a pitcher that went 16-3 with an ERA of 0.65, and we have two players going on to play Division I softball. RHS softball will truly miss this infield trio, MVP players Alexa Holland, Becky Malco, and Lexanne Holland.
This year for us, coaching the probably most successful tennis team, boys or girls, in recent memory. There are many people who could have won this award on any given night. However, these individuals tended to rise above most nights. They're a doubles team. It's tough to choose one over the other, so they both get it because they would be absolutely nowhere without the other. But they ended the year 11-3-1, which is absolutely unbelievable around here. Our most valuable this year would be Ariana Jacobs and Rosalie Navarro.
In just a moment, we'll break up for team awards. But before we do that, I'd like to say thank you to a few special people. First, I want to thank the administration at RHS, especially our corporate or our high school office. Thanks to Ann Beeler, Wendy Turneden, Tara Seifer, Kristen Horn, Jamie Bach, Lottie Smoker, Keys, and Mr. Strasser. Thanks to our athletic trainer, Christina Hughes. Thanks to our new athletic secretary, Sandy Onofield, who has done a spectacular job in her first few months on the job here. I can't thank enough Brian Stockberger, who readies all our outdoor events, and he's helped with by Bob Reed and Jim Swank. They do a tremendous service for us. We have a lot of coaches, besides the ones you see up here. For baseball, we have just two paid positions, but all these guys help out. Corey Good, Tony Stasiak, Jeff Himes, Mark Himes, Dave Ballew, Christopher Schruck, and the legendary Josh Van Meter. Where is Josh? He's slipping. For golf, Monty and Lyle, they really do a tremendous job, and they're kind of out in their own world there, and I never have any worries about what those guys are going to do except for keeping track of the keys. To the bus. In tennis, great season for Coach Atkinson, and also thanks to Tammy Hooker for helping out Coach when needed. Softball is the same kind of thing as baseball, just two paid positions, but a whole heck of a lot of people who put in time. Carla Holland, Bradley Dickinson, Andy Holland, Dave Musselman, Allie Butler, Courtney Korn, Todd Beeler, and Scott Holland all help. In track, Coach Stahlbaum, Carmen Reeves, Coach Ken Hughes, John Nile, Braxton DuBois, thanks to all of them. I do want to thank parents who, especially over the last month or two, have offered me lots of support and encouragement. Thanks for your sportsmanship at our spring events and your loyalty to RHS. I want to thank our media coverage. The Sentinel does a great job providing coverage that other schools aren't blessed with. WROI, and thanks to Channel 4, who's even recording tonight. One special group, the Rochester Boosters Club. If you're not a member, please keep in mind that the membership fees that we've collected this year have helped purchase $13,000 worth of gear. The uniforms you athletes wear and that your sons and daughters wear in large come straight from that organization. If you want to be members, just $5 a month. Contact me and I'll get you set up. They are doing a fundraiser this summer. I believe it's going to be July 18th during registration. It's $10 per person. You don't have to actually give any money. You have to come test drive a car. And for test driving the car, you will get $10 to the Booster Club. All you have to do is come take a drive. That's July 18th at registration. Encourage everybody to come to that. I especially want to thank the athletes. It's been a real pleasure, especially with these seniors, to watch you guys grow and mature, to watch you set goals and work toward them. And I, especially this year, with some of the setbacks we had, I think of some really horrific injuries that impacted our sports. And just to see especially our seniors battle through that adversity and keep positive and provide good leadership, that's something I'll miss seeing on a day-to-day basis. And I hope you guys can keep those attitudes going forward in your lives. And I hope you younger athletes saw what they did and are able to emulate that. Please keep in mind that there are always mistakes at the awards, misspellings of certificates, the wrong patches, things like that. I will be out of the office the rest of the week, but feel free to email me and I'll be glad to correct them. At this time, we are going to break up into our individual sports. Please bear in mind this. Baseball, it says you're in the auxiliary gym, but that gym is about 150 degrees right now. So we're going to put you in the main gym. The only caveat to that is please don't move the chairs. I saw the custodial staff going out and actually measuring off the distance between each chair today for graduation. So keep that in mind. Track, you're right here in the auditorium. Golf is in the library. tennis in Mr. Atkinson's room. Softball is in the cafeteria. Thank you all so much.